Hi guys, I'm back again. In this short video, I'll be talking about maintaining the spiritual cleanse after you got cleansed. Now, it's very important to stay away from negative places and negative people. And what I mean by that is, like, once you got a real powerful spiritual cleanse, you know, doesn't allow you to say, oh, I got a spiritual cleanse, I'm gonna go to the bar and celebrate with all my friends. You need to stay away from negativity and where negativity hangs. A lot of people don't understand that you're cleansed, but you can also get dirty again in a heartbeat. And it's like, it is a waste of time and money if you keep repeatedly doing that, hanging out in bad places and bad people. Because you want to be spiritually clean so that way you can have a better way of life. So, unless you have the money to keep going to the spiritual people, that you want to keep spending the money because you want to go out and have a party and have your slice of cake and the whole pie and everything else, well, more power to you. But at the same time, negative energies are going to be hanging around waiting for you to slip up so they can swoop down with you and kind of corrupt you into the darkness. So, you know, people, beware, beware. You know, get spiritual cleanse, stay on the right hand path, try not to do anything bad, you know. Don't talk down to people, don't be mean to people, be kind. And I also like to explain too, let's say if you're in the spiritual life, you know about spirituality, you know about cleansings and staying cleans and keeping away from negativity. But let's just say, for example, oh, I have a boyfriend, and my boyfriend's, he's a great guy, he's this and this and such, good looking and everything, but, you know, you're spiritually cleansed, he may not be spiritually cleansed at all. So, if you're having sex with this guy, if you're kissing with this guy, always with this guy, and he's negativity dirty, and he's got some attachments to him, well, guess what? This cleanse here ain't gonna last long, you know, because then this negativity is gonna start hanging back with you now. So, guess what? Oh, I gotta spend some more money to go get cleansed by the spiritual person. But the spiritual person is going to tell you, you know, don't be hanging around with this guy because he's no good for you. You know, he's got morero in Spanish. He's dirty, you know. He's got a lot of negative attachments to him. But you're like, oh, but he's so sweet. He's so kind. He loves me and blah, blah, blah. And you keep going back to this guy, then all this bad luck keeps coming back to you. And then you're just going to be repeatedly a vicious cycle going back and forth from this person to that person, back to this person and that person, when you need to follow the rules of spirituality. You know, you got to let go. Sometimes, you know, it hurts. Or, you know, be straight out and tell them, hey, look, I'm spirituality. I think this is what's going on in your life, this and this and this. Let's do you a cleansing. And hopefully that person accepts that type of life and is like, hey, yeah, I like to do that. It's a lot of bad luck I'm having. You know, I want to get rid of it. And shit, yeah, let's do it. You know, hopefully you can convince this person to do a cleansing as well. You know, sometimes they will accept it. Sometimes they won't. You know, so, you know, beware, beware. You know, negativity is everywhere. And you got to maintain your spiritual cleanse. Once you get spiritual cleansed by a person that is, you know, fully experienced, you know, you could do spiritual baths at home to maintain this. You know, there's herbal soaps out there with basil, rosemary, you know, spearmint, and all kinds of herbal soaps that you can just use at home to maintain the spiritual cleanse. But you gotta stay away from negative places and negativity and negative people. So I hope this small video was informative, and I shall be back.